Good evening, everybody. Thank you very much for joining in. This is 23 in the series, and today we're going to speak about how you are going to utilize your foreign exchange option contracts. Basically, every second day we are making a sense that it is predominantly important for corporate treasurers to hedge their receivable and payable using foreign exchange option contract. Well, foreign exchange option contracts are divided into two parts. The one refers to deliverable and another refers to non-deliverable. Both deliverable and non-deliverable are further divided into two parts, call option and put option. Call option and put options are further categorized into two parts, well, I'm again re-stressing the fact that deliverable option contracts refer to a contract which wherein you are going to deliver. So in nutshell and most diplomatically, as a corporate treasurer, I can say that deliverable option contracts are linked with a term which is known as cash flow hedging. On the other hand, diplomatically, I can also speak that non-deliverable forward contracts can link with a term which is known as fair value hedging. As regards call and put option are concerned, call option are the option which you are taking to, for as an importer, you think the price would move up like this, and put option is an option which you are taking as an exporter, which you are thinking price will go down like this. Call option give you a right to buy, put option give you a right to sell. Put option is also known as insurance contract. Now take a very simple example. We are going to cover one example of put option. We are going to cover the one example of call option next video, which could happen tomorrow. And I will let you know how to exercise an option contract, basically deliverable option contract, non-deliverable option contract. So this video would be categorized into four parts. Basically, we are going to have four videos where I'm going to let you know about exercise of deliverable buy put, exercise of deliverable buy call contract. And one is in deliverable space, second is in non-deliverable space. So today we're going to cover about exercise of deliverable buy put contract. Please pay attention, as this video is going to be a little technical in nature. From this side, I'm Rahul Bagan, working as a corporate treasurer in EXL Services India. I'm also acting as a treasury trainer and business consultant for various firms across the world, predominantly in Asia, and at the same time writing foreign exchange books. My first book, which is Options for Risk Free Portfolio, already published in New York, and second interest techniques to hedge your interest rate exposure is scheduled to publish in Australia by December 2014. I'm also speaking for roughly 26 global forums across the world, and also hold my three foreign exchange academies on LinkedIn, YouTube, and Dailymotion, known as titled Foreign Exchange Memory Sinkers. I'm again reiterating the fact that today we're going to speak about the exercise of an option contract which is deliverable in attitude, however buy put. Now pay attention here. We're going to speak about deliverable buy put contract. I take a very simple example. We're going to take simple example as to make it very clear. Infosys is selling $100 million, assuming today's spot is going 62 and forward premium for 1 year is 5 rupees, so the net outright is 67. And Infosys, obviously we know that in buy put is also known as insurance contract, so you have to take out of the money contract. So Infosys would be taking 62 plus 7, which is 67. Infosys is taking a contract at 65, or let's assume 64, which is known as out of the money. What do you mean by out of the money? Out of the money is a contract, basically something which is readily available to sell at 67, you are selling it at 64. It means you yourself giving a chance to bank a profit of 3 rupee. In compensation, bank would tell you that I'm compensating you in the form of almost zero premium. Please be noted that I'm using a diplomatic term which is known as almost zero premium, which means almost no premium. That doesn't mean zero premium, it means almost negligible premium. So Infosys sold $100 million for 1 year using buy put contract at 64 per dollar on maturity. Today is what? Today is 19th of August 14, and they had taken for 18th of August 14, 15. On 18th August 15, how you would determine that how exercise should work? 18th August 15 at 11 a.m. IST or 3 p.m. Japanese time, Japanese come Tokyo time, there would be a fixing that hit the system, and that fixing is known as Tokyo cut. So Tokyo cut will come at, as you, I would take the 3 rate of Tokyo cut. Tokyo cut comes at 65, 62 and 66. If Tokyo cut will come at 65, you have a right to sell at 64. Would you do? No. You let your option worthless and you sell in market. If you have a right to come at 64, Tokyo cut coming at 62, you would exercise your right. You would have a cash gain of 2 into 100, 10 raised to the power 6 divided by 62. If it is 66, again the same result will happen. It would be worthless and it will go to the market. Please be note that option exercise, whether it is a buy call contract, it's a buy put contract for USD INR, whether it's a deliverable, it's a non-deliverable. That's happened via Tokyo cut. There are 5 cuts we have in the system. I'm just explaining in a brief way. The first cut we have is a Tokyo cut, which is 3 p.m. Tokyo time. The second cut we are having, it can also be misnomerly termed as FDI cut, but this is not a FDI cut, right? Second is known as London cut, which is 4 p.m. London time. Third is known as Frankfurt cut. Fourth is known as New York cut, 10 a.m. New York time. All American options done by whether European investors or American investors, they are on New York cut. Frankfurt cut is least used, London cut so as London cut, but Tokyo cut is basically for all Asian currencies, predominantly Singapore, Hong Kong, Thailand, India and all. In India, Tokyo cut is misnomerly referred to as FDI cut as well. At the end, I would like to reiterate the fact that all the options expiry are happened on Tokyo cut for USD INR in India. For Philippines, it's also Tokyo cut, and so on and so forth. Next video, we are going to cover about deliverable buy call, then non-deliverable buy put, and deliverable and non-deliverable buy call. You're most welcome to contact me at 9198992429978. You can contact me at rahullogan8@gmail.com. You can contact my LinkedIn also at Foreign Exchange, my LinkedIn Academy, Foreign Exchange, Maverick Thinkers, which is right now available on 3, which is on LinkedIn, which is on YouTube and Dailymotion. Thank you very much for joining in. Thanks for your time and have a great evening as well.